Residents in the so-called Embo villages again bearing the brunt of a territorial dispute between Taguig and Makati. This is after Makati announced 10 of the transferred villages can no longer access health benefits available under Makati's yellow and blue card programs. Rafael Bosano reports.
Reynaldo Tamboleago suffered a stroke in 2021. A year later, he was hospitalized for another illness. In both situations, he didn't pay a single centavo in hospital bills. See, Tamboleago is a Makati resident and all the expenses were covered by his yellow card. However, this year, he loses the benefits provided by the Makati city government after West Rembo, where he lives, and 9 other Embo villages were ruled by the Supreme Court to be under the jurisdiction of Taguig City. In its Facebook page, the Makati City government said that beginning January 1, 2024, residents in Embo villages can no longer use their yellow cards except if they're an employee of the Makati government. The Makati LGU adds while it wants to continue the operation of health centers and lying-in clinics in the 10 villages, the local government has no choice but to close down these facilities after their licenses to operate lapsed. Like many residents, Tamboleago says, it's a major worry.
Yan nga sir, yung pinangambahan ko eh. Sana wag lang sana ako magkasakit ulit.
Kasi?
Oh, wala na yung hospital, wala na lahat. Sana ko kung hospital ako, wala na ako pang bayad. Sumasakit na naman ang ulo ko eh. So, yan ay, pinag-suggest ko na lang.
Aside from the yellow cards, elderly residents of Embo villages also enjoy benefits offered by their so-called blue card. However, this too is no longer valid. Despite this, the local government says they can still use the Makati Zen card as a valid ID and debit card. At least one Embo resident hopes the Taguig LGU would at least match or exceed the benefits provided by Makati City.
Balita ko tungkol sa Taguig, tungkol sa mga gamot. Libre naman daw ang mga gamot sa mga senior at saka magpa-check sa doktor. Sana po, mas higitan pa ni Mayor Lani Cayetano ang binibigay ng Makati.
Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.
Now, Taguig City says it is now offering free consultation and 24-hour health services to over 200,000 residents affected by that territorial dispute. Taguig said the so-called Embo residents can avail of these free services in the city's health centers.
The Commission on Higher Education reminds state universities and colleges to discontinue their senior high school programs. It says the programs should only be offered during the K-12 transition period that ended in 2021. CHED Chairman Prospero De Vera explained there should be no more government assistance to student and teacher beneficiaries for school year 2023 to 2024.
A former Philippine lawmaker raises the alarm over the chilling effect of the Anti-Terrorism Act on the political opposition. This is a day after the Supreme Court released its implementing rules for the law. Attorney Nery Colmenares, one of the petitioners against the law, says it's meant to silence the opposition. He also suspects authorities will continue to conduct surveillance activities on suspected terrorists even without an order from the Court of Appeals. Colmenares insists an anti-terror law is the last thing that the Philippines needs, as there are other laws that address terrorism. The total number of firecracker-related injuries in the Philippines, it's 557. The Health Department recorded 114 new cases from January 2 to 3. The majority of the cases were due to firecrackers. Some even resulted in amputations. A 6-year-old priest in Baguio City was also hit by a stray bullet during the New Year revelries. He is in stable condition. Here at home, the Philippine government is set to launch more floating assets in the West Philippine Sea. The Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources says these assets are meant to help Filipino fishermen and assert Manila's sovereignty in waters illegally claimed by China. The agency, however, did not provide specifics on what form these assets will take. The BFAR also says they are in close coordination with the National Task Force on the West Philippine Sea.
Doon po kami sumisentro sa paggawa ng mga programa para po sa West Philippine Sea. Masiguro natin na mayroong livelihood opportunities, may tamang suporta ang ating mga mangisda dyan dahil alam naman po natin, kinikilala natin sa ngayon na mayroon tayong hamon na hinaharap sa West Philippine Sea. Pero hindi naman ibig sabihin ito dahil may hamon tayong hinaharap ay titigil na tayo sa pagpapatupad ng ating mga programa.
Philippine state seismologists not expecting any damage to infrastructure in Surigao del Sur after a magnitude 5.1 quake rattled the eastern Mindanao province. The country's chief seismologist, Teresita Bacolcol, says the tremor is an aftershock of the magnitude 7.4 quake that hit eastern Mindanao in December. Meanwhile, Bacolcol assures the public the Bulusan volcano is not erupting anytime soon despite its heightened seismic activity. But he urges local governments and the public to stay away from the volcano's 4-kilometer permanent danger zone.
There are other parameters that we are watching, such as elevated levels of steam or gas emission, sustained inflation of the edifice of the edifice of Bulusan volcano, and increase in hot spring temperature. So if there are sustained increases in these parameters, then we have to raise this to alert level 2.
Another tragedy in Japan. Authorities are looking into negligence as a possible cause in the Tokyo runway collision that left 5 people dead. The police probe got underway as officials began looking for clues in the charred wreckage of a Japan Airlines plane. The escape of all 379 people on board the Airbus A350 on Tuesday was deemed a miracle after it erupted into flames after colliding with a smaller aircraft. 5 of the 6 Coast Guard crew on board the Dash 8 plane were killed. They were previously responding to the earthquake in Noto Peninsula. Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida says delivery of aid to quake-hit areas are unaffected.
With regards to your question about whether the accident at Haneda Airport is affecting delivery of aid to quake-hit zones, at the moment, various ministries are working together and have secured various routes. I believe the accident at Haneda Airport has had no impact on aid delivery.
The accident has not been affected by the accident.